everyone, welcome to another Halloween themed video. Today's video is going to be a kind of relaxed tapping video on autumnal and like Halloween objects, like decorational objects, party objects, that sort of thing. I've accumulated quite a few new bits this year for different reasons. One, because we are staying in the house this year because of COVID. The last 3 years we have actually gone on holiday for Halloween to a really cool place in the UK that has like scare mazes and a Halloween circus and a kids show, like a free show for kids, Halloween parties and costume parties, that sort of thing. And obviously this year they are not doing most of those things, so instead of going anyway and not enjoying it as much, we are going to have like a little party for ourselves in the house. So I wanted to buy some new decorations, and I absolutely love, like I've said in the other videos, I love this time of year and autumn. It makes me feel warm and cozy and happy. So this year I went out and bought some autumnal bits to decorate as well, just to make me feel a little bit better, like numb. So I thought I would just get fake ones this year to decorate with. Plus I can have them out for as long as possible without them sticking. So I got two packs of like pumpkins and autumn decorations, and I have decorated my living room coffee table. I bought this like log, it's like a fake, it's actually a cake stand. I've got food dye on my thumb from doing experiments with my son. What was I saying? Yes, I've got a food stand, it's a log. And I decorated it with some of the autumnal bits that I bought. If I can take a clip of what I've decorated so far, I will like insert it somewhere. We haven't properly decorated for Halloween yet. I've just put some, like I say, autumn bits out. We are going to properly decorate this week. But I like this pumpkin. I like the way that it's shaped. Not a perfect pumpkin. Okay, we've got quite a lot to get through, so I won't spend too long on one item. Here we have another pumpkin from the set. Small metal stock. bubbly, spotty one. This is a little, looks like it's been infected, an infected pumpkin. Then we have this tiny little cute one. It kind of looks like a bit of an orange. It looks more yellow on camera, but it's not. It's orange. My lighting's not working very well today. Yes, I like this little clute one. So it's actually really, really orange, and then obviously it's got white flecks. These two little pine cones that came with one of the pumpkin sets. So this is decorated on my coffee table. Won't stop. On my hand just before filming, it's so annoying. The rain has started. I'm filming in a little hut that's in my garden. It's not little, it's a big hut. It's a bar. So if you can hear the wind and the rain, I kind of apologise, but then again it kind of adds autumn weather and background noise. I know some people don't like background noise, and I apologise if you don't, but sometimes I think an ASMR video that's pin silent in the background and it's just talking or whatever it is the person's doing, it's, I don't always find that super relaxing. I kind of like white noise or background sounds. I know not everyone's the same, but I like to try and cater for everybody on this channel. Sometimes it's hard when you've not got a proper space to film, or you've not got you know, really good equipment. It's difficult, but I try my best. So I have some videos that are and have no background noise and that are really quiet, and then some that do. So it's a bit of both. So now we have these itty bitty tiny little acorns. They are so small. They make a little bit of sound. So these came with the pumpkins and the pine cones. These are fake. They've been made with foam, I think, and then painted. These remind me of Ice Age, when the little, I don't know what it is, like half squirrel, half rat thing, collects them and tries to bury them. They're a lot bigger than this though. Sit on the little centerpiece. I think that sits on the centerpiece on the table at these little leaves, which make really nice fabric sounds. So you get different, you've got like a red and brown, another red and brown, then more of an orange and red. It looks yellow on there, but it's not, it's this bit's orange. And there's a couple stuck together. And then you've got more yellow with a tiny bit of orange at the top. So these came with the set too. My, I'll change one of them to the orange one. If anybody watched my, one of my last videos, the Halloween films and shows, recommendations, suggestions, that sounds really nice. I like the sound of that. Yeah, the Halloween movies and shows suggestions. I hadn't watched a couple of things at the time of filming that. One of them was The Haunting of Bly Manor, and the other one was Hubie Halloween, both on Netflix. I didn't like Bly Manor as much as Hill House. And I didn't know until it started that they were not at all related to one another, but they have the some of the same actors in. So I didn't know that, which that kind of reminds me a bit of American Horror Story, so I wasn't too bothered by that. But I just didn't really like it that much. It was a bit slow in places. Personally, I don't think it was very spooky, scary, or even a bit thriller-like. I think the first three or four episodes were really, really good. And then after that, I wasn't a fan. But if you haven't watched it yet, then give it a go. I mean, everybody's different. Just because I didn't like it doesn't mean you won't. And Hubie's Halloween. I wanted to like it so, so bad. I wanted it to be really, really good. And I would say it was good, but it wasn't great. I feel like it could have been 10 times better. I think it could have been 10 times funnier. I feel like if that film was made 10 to 15 years ago, that would have been one of the best Halloween films ever. It would have been hilarious. It just would have been really good. So I didn't like it as much as I really wanted to. I really wanted to have a new favourite autumn Halloween movie, but unfortunately I didn't. But again, I mean, you might like it. I didn't like it as much as I wanted to. I really like the sound of these. I could do this all day, to be honest. Leaves. I'm going to turn these on. I have these leaf fairy lights that flash. I think I'm going to keep them flashing. So I actually doubled them up. They should be a lot longer, but I doubled them up because of where I put them. I've used these in a background for a video that you will see probably after this one. So keep an eye out for that. Don't really know what sounds I can make with this. Oh. Something like this for so long and just never got around to getting them. If you see sellotape, that is because I've sellotaped them together, like I doubled them up and they wouldn't stay, so I had to sellotape them, which is very professional. That's how we do things around here. Either everything's sellotaped or blue dot. So these I have already decorated with. I've just took them from their place. They go over my mirror in my living room. I wouldn't say that I go ridiculously over the top decorating, but I do like to decorate a little bit. I think it puts you right in the mood to watch Halloween films. So you will see them in my next video. was not anticipating this video to be as long as it is already, so I'm either going to go through the rest of the items quite quickly or just miss some of them out that are a bit irrelevant. So the next items we have are from some bunting, which you will see again in my next video. I use it for the background, but these are the ones that didn't make it onto the bunting ribbon because there was too many. I found these on eBay and absolutely fell in love with them. So this is the first one, and then you've got that, so they kind of repeat. Do you know what I mean? So they're the two patterns for this one. So I wanted to get a more Halloween one. They make really good tapping sounds. And scratching. So these, like I say, are on eBay. I might try and link them down below. The woman, I think it's a woman or a company, makes loads and loads of different styles of Halloween ones. There are some Alice in Wonderland themed ones. There are some Christmas themed ones. So you will probably see some Christmas themed ones in December in a video. But on here it says, happy Halloween. We have one little bat up here, and then another little bat here, and then we have two carved pumpkins, and then this little fella here, and then another little I'm not sure. So that's that one. And then the next one is trick or treat. These I have already decorated with on my radiator covers. Do that, like hanging on the radiator covers. But yeah, so these are the Halloween ones. These more autumnal ones, but they're still Halloween, but I love them. These would look really nice in a cafe. So they're the same type of material, they're the same size. This one says, spice life. I missed spice. Spice life. Pumpkin. Spice life. And then we have a drink here with whipped cream and cinnamon, or maybe chocolate. We have cinnamon sticks here. And then we have an autumn leaf here. And then a decorative pattern with a little pumpkin in the middle. this one, which says you had me at pumpkin spice. And again with a decorative pattern up here with a little pumpkin. A mug of what looks like hot chocolate and some autumn leaves. So they are so pretty. I don't think you could get any more autumnal than that. And then these hang on my other radiator covers. And again, they like go like that, and then there's another one of that one, and then another one of that one. I think that's pretty much it for just autumnal decorations. The rest are pretty much Halloween, cheesy Halloween, cheapy tacky Halloween, party-ish decorations. The next ones we have are these, like paper pumpkins. Just got these to stick on the end of my TV unit, like so. Away, so I'm hoping to keep them for next year too. There are two of those. Next we have these lights. I've not used them yet. They're still tied up. But I do already have some green spider lights, so I wanted to put some more. Oh, that flickered. See that one flicker? Not really much sounds I can make with these. Do they look nice and spooky and Halloween-y? Functioning one. So I've got two of those. I usually do buy like two of each because I like to be symmetrical. And then we have two pumpkin lights. These have got little faces on. These these are orange. This one again has a plaster on, not a plaster, what's it called, sellotape on it, because they are broke. Plaster. Maybe I should put plaster on that Halloween one. So you can either hang these up or I sit them next to the TV. Skeleton. And this one looks more like he's been wrapped up like a mummy. I never noticed that before. Men. We have this, it's not been opened yet, so I'll just make some package sounds. And it's just a spider's web with spiders. Did have a web before, but it was far too stringy and annoying, so I bought a new one. This is going to go on staircase. Was just bought on eBay. I think it was like £2.60, something like that. Stick with the theme of things that's not been opened yet. So I have this hanging back decoration still in the packet. It's three meters long, so I think that looks super cool. It's not open yet, but it's going to be open very soon. Again, this was just on eBay for a couple of pounds, I'm not sure how much exactly. And next we have this, which is quite big. It's just a cardboard image, palmistry image, which I thought would go well with the decorations. I just really like the look of this. It's quite witchy, spooky looking. It's a little damaged, which is annoying because it was delivered. I didn't go into the shop to get it. This was from Asda. So, yep, that's going to go somewhere. I'll either hang it up or just rest it on a table or something. We have three items left, you'll be pleased to know. Well, this one is a little stuck. Come on, friend. There we go. We have a giant, goodness, glow in the dark skeleton who jingles about a bit. He only glows in the dark when he's been put in the sun or under the bright light. But he's quite cool. I usually just like hang him on the wall. So I think he was from, he's a couple of years old, he's not new. He's been around a while. I think he was from Wilkinson's or the Pound Shop. Okay, so we have two items left and they are both bunting. This one is long and it's pumpkin, paper pumpkins. So it's quite hard to hold them all. So I think I'm just gonna like close them and then open them. Can you hear the storm outside now? It's cozy. This bunting is actually a few years old and I've tried to keep it every year and it gets a little more squished and damaged every year. But is also bunting. I'm just going to show you the top half of it and then I am going to outro with this trigger. Okay, so I hope that you did enjoy this video. So this bunting says trick and it hangs at the top, and then there is another bit that says or treat trick. What does it say? Trick, yeah. Trick, and then the bottom one says or treat. So. So this is a new piece of bunting I'm looking forward to putting up. Folded it up to tap on it to make it easier.